You're evoking some hollering from the crowd here. So now I was reading through your notes, and you want to have a PhD in psychology too?
I do want to have that.
Where do you stand now in your?
I just 3 weeks ago finished the master's, so yeah? I have 2 years in a dissertation.
And what's your particular discipline in the psychological field?
Do you know a lot about this?
Oh, I've been in therapy since I was 17.
Since you're 17?
Well, that's when I first started. Yeah, when I was 17, and I got out last week. I hadn't left the room. And yeah, off and on, here and there. I find the unexplored life is kind of boring to me. I like to find out what makes me tick. So yeah, I go a lot.
And what do you do? What type of therapy do you?
Well, I've dabbled in Jung, Freud, and just pragmatism. You know, the three of those. I kind of. Which one do you lean towards?
Family systems theory.
You baffled me there.
Like, whatever we do in a family, we go out and do in the outside world.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever dysfunction you have there, you kind of play the same role.
Yeah.
When you get married or when you're in the outside world. So it's taking care of the family, mm-hmm. and taking care of what role you play there and taking care of the pathology. So you don't go do it later on.
Point where I sometimes wonder why I'm in show business. How needy am I that I'm in show business? Because essentially it's a pretty... You know, you're really trying to evoke some response to yourself. What role did you not get enough attention that you feel you have to go out now and be in show business? Well, I'm not saying that mean, but maybe you didn't.
I think that anyone that does this or that, there's a little bit of... Not the cameraman.
Okay.
There's a little bit of narcissism,
yeah,
attached to it. And I don't think it's a bad thing. I think it's a need to express yourself and get feedback from that expression. And so I think you're taking care of yourself.
Right. I agree with you. No, I always cop to my neediness about show business. I think if you were completely self-contained, the thought that you would go out and solicit the approval of strangers would seem odd to me. You know, you'd have it, sort of, you know? You wouldn't do your dance for it. That's why performers eventually get pissed off at what they do, because it makes them resent that they have to do some dance for what they probably felt they should have got au naturel all along. Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Sorry, that'll be $85. Now, no wonder Lynch finds you interesting, because I always view him as sort of a, you know, I'm sure he likes thoughtful women, and you seem to be of that ilk. How are you getting along with him? You having fun?
I love him.
Yeah? Sexually, or just...
No, he's like daddy / brother / whatever...
Guru auteur?
/ genius /
yeah.
Buddy, can I stop?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's / guitarist for...
Guns N' Roses.
Roses. Okay. The show is on the air. We've had Ian on. I know what it's about to some extent. It's like a kind of a weird show in the 50s on TV
that's not quite making it.
I think we have a clip that I want to show before we move further along.
Oh, we do?
Do you know what it's about? Or?
Yeah, this is basically my character who is not exactly a genius, and she is trying to find out what she's going to do on the show this week.
Uh-huh.
And so she's talking to the director who doesn't speak English. I don't know, it's a strange
thing. Sounds Lynchian.
It's very Lynchian.
Roll it.
Sir, when would you like me to rehearse the kitchen scene?
Who is your name? Your ironing.
How is your ironing?
Betty, how is your ironing?
My mother does my ironing.
But Betty, your mother is knit on the sun.
My mother's at home.
And how is your mother, you poor girl?
Well, she's excited, but honestly, Mr. Gushnick and my mother have to iron. She's gonna miss the show tonight.
For a second. Watch up on the television in her own home.
But it's in the other room and the cord doesn't reach.
Wow. That's different. It's different. Now, you know, that makes the midget dancing look like Bonanza, for God's sake. This looks like a weird show.
Yeah, you know, I didn't think so when I was doing it, but... But that clip makes me realize you're right.
Well, I'm sure there'll be a big interest. People like, you know, TV's sort of prepackaged. They like it when it's a little funkier like that. I'm sure you'll have an audience. You're doing WKRP, too. What are you going to do? You got to pick one or the other?
No, I'm doing both.
Yeah, you can juggle them both?
Well, yeah.
And the shrink thing?
And the shrink thing. The shrink thing took a long time.
I know, that's what I'm saying. How are you going to keep all this up in the air?
The great thing is MTM is the studio I work at, and WKRP is 100 feet from on the air, so I just get out a costume, run, and put the 50s costume on, and do that, and then go study at night for school. And
you keep it all going. You're a 90s gal.
I am a 90s gal.
Myla Rubinoff. Good luck with it.
Thank
Myla,
you.
We'll be right back with Gary Player right after this.